Hi, welcome back to a brand new coffee tech break with Jan. Now, hopefully you enjoyed my last video with the unboxing of the P5. I got another box that came in, and let me show you the unboxing of this one. Now, it is a little bit, it is quite big. It is same nice look and feel, poly branding box, and it looks a little bit of the size of X30. And so if you compare that, well, it could even fit in here. So take it like this. There you go. So it could even fit in there. So what will it be? Very nice one. Let me show you. It's always an exciting moment, also for me, trying to get those products for my channel and to show it to you, and of course give you some tips and tricks. And here you go. I guess you now know what it is. This is the Poly P15, and here are the instructions, which are already coming to me. You got here some life saving instructions, so I would say save them for the weekend. A quick start guide, which I will walk you through. So just let me quickly show you the quick start guide. So here you got some information about the connectors, etc. But as usual, I will show you all that. Here you can also got the instructions, etc. How to use it, probably something you quickly want to browse through. Now, what is more? Of course, the P15. Let me take it out and talk you to the details a bit later on. Nice package in plastic. What more do we have? So we can take this off. Here you go. So a power cable, very important. A Euro cable. So what do we have here? The clamp. So it's a sort of similar clamp, you know, from the X30, which you can really move like this, and there's no tools needed. I think that is also an important one. So as you can see, it's got a little bit of screw with a tool, so you can easily use this without any screwdrivers or something. So we have that. We got the power supply, course, and the power supply is 12 volts, 3 ampere. It's also with the Euro connector, and this is the one on the other side. What do we have more? A cable, as you can see. So I will show you the length, of course. This is USB-C to USB-C. If you need to change that, then you probably want to look for an adapter. So there's nothing more in here. You probably want to look for an adapter to change that to USB-A if that is needed on your specific computer. Now, let me take this guy out of the plastic. So what do we have? We got the P15. We got the USB cable, the 3.0 cable. We got a clamp, we have power supply, and the Euro cable. All right. Now, let me talk about the P15. Very, very nice, and show it to you. So it's a sort of similar size as the X30. So let me pick up the X30 to compare it to you. So here you go. This is the X30. And also, if you look at the side, it's a sort of similar at the back. See, sort of similar size, and also on this side. Now, what is very important to take that and talk that through immediately, X30 is for a conference room, 120-degree camera, building codec, can be used hybrid, so can be used as a USB peripheral to use speaker, camera, and mic, but also use as a codec. You can run apps on this device, so you don't need your laptop when walking into the room. The P15 is a personal, the P for personal, so just like the P5, which I showed you earlier, and this will be my partner in crime a bit later to show you the connectors on this device. The P15 is for the personal use case. Now, that doesn't mean you cannot use it in a conference room or in a huddle space or a small space. If people want to do that, that is possible. But keep in mind that it's specifically made for the home office, executive office, management office. Because what we see today is, COVID is here to stay. So there will be still a lot of people working from home. And for sure, they're going to look for better and higher quality solutions to work in the home office. And I think this guy, the P15, really works well. And you got everything all in one, but no codec inside. So you always need to use your laptop, connect that through the USB cable. It's got Team certification, Zoom certification, but you can use it. It's UVC compatible with the laptop, so you can connect it through any video client that runs on your laptop. That shouldn't be an issue. Now, let me take you a little bit through the optics. So there is a high quality lens in here, a 4K lens. So it can do some group framing, some framing in your personal room. Depending on where you're sitting, it's a 4K lens. So it will frame you within that 4K in the room. So if you stand up, if you sit down, it will automatically try to get you to put you in the best picture. I think that's also very, very nice. Now, the look and feel is sort of the same. So it's the material also. It's the sort of the same refurbished plastic that we use with the X30. And an X50, very, very nice. Now, let me show you now the connectors. And to do that, I will take my partner in crime, the P5 with the Lightning. I will take that and show you the connectors on this device. Now, take a cup of coffee. As I would usually say, welcome to my new close-up shots, where I'm using now that P5, which I showed you in my previous video, with some additional lighting on the products, which I think is a very powerful use case for me as a streamer, but also in a product development, engineering, manufacturing. I can imagine this is a very nice use case. Now, let me take you through those options, because I think that is very nice. So underneath the P15, you got a couple of connectors, and let me try to show you that. So first off, you got a USB hub inside. Now, why is that interesting? It's using a port on your laptop. So here you get two ports additional back, and these are just a hub. So you can connect, if you got a wired headset, you just connect them to this port and you're able to use that. I will show you a bit later also the Poly Lens app. So this will automatically detect this device, so you can change some settings, etc. So I will show you that a bit later. Now, so you can use these ports for anything. These are 2.0 ports, 2.0 USB ports, but that should be nice for your audio devices. Now, thinking of audio devices, you could also use the BT600, that dongle. And so you can easily just put that in here into one of those ports, and you have the dongle in here. And what you can do, if you got a sort of bigger home office, you could even combine that then with the Sync, the Sync 20, the Sync 40, or the Sync 60. You could really combine it. So you could make a very nice home kit. Now, thinking of the Sync 40 and Sync 60, you can even daisy chain those two devices, which I think is really, if you got a really nice executive home office, but you can do it. So you got quite some additional nice options there to use at home. And now, this is the USB hub, which is built into this device underneath. The other one is here is the tripod connector. So here, and I will show you that a bit later, you can connect also this device. So you could easily put it in there or using a tripod, which I will show you. You can also use that right there. Now, further, as I will show you, you got here the power connector, so you could easily connect there the power underneath. Here you got the USB-C. This is the one which goes to the laptop, so it will automatically be detected by the laptop as camera, speaker, and mic. And here you got a reset button, factory reset button, and the Kensington lock. To make sure that your kids at home don't take it out of your office, which I can tell you, my son is doing a lot. When he sees a camera here, he is already enthusiastic and usually takes it away. So this is underneath the P15. Now, what is on the back? Not very much besides here the hole for the power, probably to release some heat, but also for the sound quality, that you got the sound chamber that you can also give that some room for the audio. Yeah, and on the front side, as you can see here, you got the lens details. So there is a 4K lens in here, it's set specifically for the framing, because usually in Teams or in Zoom or any client, they usually do full HD, 1080p, so that should be sufficient. But with the 4K in here, you're ready for the future, but also the framing works very nice. The field of view is 90 degrees, so it can pick up 90 degrees in your room. I think for home office that is perfect. So the P5 was like 80 degrees and this is 90 degrees. So you don't need to take a lot of view in the room, specifically in your home office. So 90 degrees should be really sufficient. Now let's get back to our big view to show you it. So the options. So what comes along is the clamp. Very important. So you attach the clamp by just putting on top of it with the screw. And I think that's very nice. You just screw that. You can do that without screwdrivers. And you can adjust that to your own needs. So as you see here, there's sort of gliding. And it glides also, as you can see here, in that two spaces, so it really glides, and you can slide this depending on how you want to put this on top of your screen. So you really got some flexibility, and also this can move very flexible. There's some rubber also here, so you can easily put this on top of your screen and to make sure that it fits. And also here you got that flexibility to fit it on your screen. Very nice. So you could just put it on top of your screen, connected to the laptop, and you could use it. Now, this is a use case, and also the other use case, let me show you that quickly, is with the tripod. So if I disconnect this, and now let me use, for example, a tripod there, it's also a possibility. Here you go. Right, so you can also use it this way and connect it with a tripod. So now you have the flexibility as a streamer to easily put that in your room on top of a table. Now, lastly, what I wanted to show you, there's a cable coming along. So let me show you at least the length of the cable, because I think that is a very nice one. The cable is around 1.30 meters, 1.40 meters. So that should be sufficient for your home office to put it set on your screen, to your laptop, etc. So this cable comes along. As I said, if you need to change it to USB-A, I recommend to get an adapter. Also from Poly, we have those small adapters. So that should be all good. Now, the use case for this device is that you always need to use a laptop. There's no codec inside. Keep that in mind. What you're doing is you bring the audio to this device. So it's got a speaker built in, a high quality speaker. It takes the camera so you can make a good shot. And there's multiple microphones in here. And I will show you in the Lens app what exactly you can configure. But there is acoustic fans, so you can create a sort of wall in your room where the microphone needs to pick up. And also there's a noise block in there, Noise Block AI, which is an engine which can block out any other noise than voice. And that is all built into this device. There's nothing you need to do at your at the laptop side. It's all built into this device, and you can tweak that by the Lens app. So let me now take you through the Lens app and connect this device to show you what sort of features you have in there. Now powered on, so it's connected USB cable to the laptop, and what you also see here on the top, a white light. So that means that the device is enabled, as you will see there, a white light, and that will become green as soon as the camera is enabled, which I will show you. This white light, by the way, goes off when I'm using this privacy shutter. Don't know if I showed that already, but we got that privacy shutter here. So in case you don't want to be in a video, you can always close it down. So the shutter is something you can rotate here on the side, as you can see, and it shutters the camera. And then also the white light is off, which means camera is also turned off. Now, I will show you that a bit later also when the camera is on and what the behavior is. So this shutter is also available. Now, what that means is when you use the shutter, the audio is still there. So the microphone is still working. It's similar like with the P5. So you can also shutter the camera, but be aware that the mic is still on. Now, here you see the Lens app. So you can use that standalone. Let's say I got one P15, then you can use that standalone as a user to change some settings. But if you're in a corporate, you can also use that in combination with Lens in the cloud. And as I also talked you through in my previous session. So with Lens in the cloud, as an admin, you got an overview of your devices, serial numbers, and you can also make some policies in the future, etc., for those devices. Give them some specific software which needs to be on those machines. So this is a development which is going on at the moment. Now, as I connect the P15, so let me show you that. You see that it's popping up right here. You can see it is connected as a status. You can see the software version, the firmware. If there is a new version, it will show you that here, so you can push it out. And this is all what is right here. There's also here a factory reset. So if you taking out the unit or you want to restore it for some reason, there's always a factory reset button right there. Now, what more options do we have? As you can see, there is a control tab here. The preview is hidden by default there. So if you need to enable that, you need to click here on show, as you see right here. And what will happen is, let me show you that. You're also in view. As soon as I click on enable that, what you will see, here you go. You see now that the light is now green. And that means it's turned on. So the camera is now turned on. If I rotate it, you see that the green light is off, and that means the camera is off. So you got really good indication when the camera is on and the camera is off. Really, really nice. So here you got some different settings available. So you can make it full screen. You can make a snapshot. You can set up a raster. You can do some manual ETC, etc. That is available there. Now, what I also really like is you can set some favorites for your different rooms. So here you see, for example, kitchen, You see the garage, and you can really create some favorites here, edit, and maybe you sit in the kids' room at some point of time. I see people in this period of time sitting everywhere. So you can really change those favorites right here and set your preferred lighting and everything. You can set that right here. So you got backlight compensation, got tracking mode. Tracking mode is set to group or to off, as you see right here. So you can turn it off if you want to put the camera fixed in the room. Now, if you want to use the auto framing, you set it to group. And that means the camera will automatically follow you in the room. But if you sit with multiple persons, it will automatically zoom out, which I think is very, very powerful for this device. You've seen the same functionality with Studio X and also with the Studio USB. The maximum zoom. So here you can set your maximum digital zoom to 4 times or 2 times. Usually 2 times should be sufficient. Now if you really want to zoom into a person, you can put it into 4 times if you want. Camera movements, that means how you want to make the shot. So you got auto pan, which means the transition is really smooth where you're going to move around in the room. Or you can put it to cut, which means it will make a shot. If you then move around, it will directly move to that other shot where you are. So depending on how you want to make the video camera movements. So this is, I usually leave it to auto pan, which I think is really nice. It gives that nice smooth pan and zoom. Camera tracking, that is normal, fast or slow. And that means how fast do you want to do that movement, so you can really customize that. And the frame size. So depending on what you want to see of the room and the person. And I usually leave that to medium. So you see a bit of the room and the person is framed in the middle. Now, all customizable. So I think this is really powerful. Even if you do a reboot, it will stay there. So these settings will persist really on the device itself. So that is the controls. The next step is the settings. So what can we do in the settings? That is also a very interesting one. These are those audio, those acoustic features which I talked about earlier. There's multiple microphones in here, and we can use that, which we call acoustic fans. So if I want to block out any other noise, and I can imagine that in a home office or executive office, at some point of time, people will be standing at the door, dinner time, lunch, coffee, etc. You can block out that noise outside the fence. So you can here program your fence. So you want it narrow, means you really need to sit in front of the P15. You could put the medium, so the microphones are a little bit wider. If you put it wide, microphones are really wide. So it's really how you want to tweak the microphones in front of the P15. Very, very powerful. I leave them off now. The Noise Block AI engine, that means it's able to block out any other noise than voice. So if I'm talking and there is a dog barking, trash bin is being picked up, etc., there's always something happening at home office, it will be able to block it. And if you're not talking and you're typing on your keyboard there, which is happening a lot, it will block it. So it's really giving you a great experience and solving a lot of those issues at home, which you usually don't think of, but your remote participants will really love that experience. Now, here you can set the anti-flicker settings to 50 or 60 hertz, depending on your home office for the lightning. Here you're able to tweak a little bit of the bass and the treble, and you got the restore default. So if something is happening with the device, you use the restore button underneath, or you can use here that button in the Lens app. Now, and the other last step here is support. So you got your quick start guide, a user guide, you got a device log. So if you need to download some logs for the support, support. If you need them, upload some specific software have for testing, you can do that also here. And of course, if you are in contact with support, you need some information. This information will also be used centrally from the LAN side, which I will show you. So this is all USB connected devices to my Windows machine or to my Mac. And so you can see directly what I've been using. Now, to show you, for example, when you connect a device that it is detected here, is I have here a black wire 8225 around my neck. And let me now connect this device into the hub and show you that it is automatically popping up in the Lens app. So I just connected it. And now what you will see in the Lens app here, that it will be able to detect it and show you that. And here you go, the Poly Blackwire 8225. As you see, it is detected now. So automatically comes in this list, and then you can configure it. So this is the thing. And with the Lens app, you can configure all your clients, do software updates, you can tweak the settings, etc. I think that is really powerful. And there's a lot of development going on. So if the product is not 100% supported yet, just watch out for it a little bit later, and it might be supported. Now, what I recommend is if you use the Plantronics Hub client, make sure you close that app. So don't run all those apps at the same time. I know there will be running both of them for a while, or you use the Hub or you use Lens, but at the end, the Lens app should be your one stop for all your device support. Now, let me show you also in the Lens Cloud. So this is the portal in the Lens Cloud where I can log in as an admin to show you that I'm able to find those devices over there. So I can go here to inventory, and I see here the list of devices that are connected. And here I can search for the P15. And as you can see, it detected I'm online, and I can go to the details. And here you can find also all the details of the device, serial numbers, etc. So I think it's a really powerful platform. And also in this list, in the inventory list, you can see all other devices. So if I have a standalone, the X30 here in my home office as a standalone codec, you can also put that in Lens. So all the devices could be managed through Poly Lens through the cloud. Now, as I said, I will put a link in the comments. So if you want to play with the Lens app and the standalone client, you're able to download that and use it. Now, finally, what I wanted to show you is when you use this on your laptop, make sure you check this as a speaker, mic, and camera. So that will be used by Teams. Usually it's automatically been set up as a preferred device, as it is a Teams qualified device, but you can always double check that. So you go here to settings, you go to devices, and what you need to check is that it is here selected as Poly P15 audio. Same thing, we'll probably set it as a speaker, as a microphone. And here you can check if the P15 is set for the video, and then you're ready to go. Now, the same with Zoom. You go to the Zoom client, go to video, and check if the video is connected from the P15. Go to the audio tab, and you can also check here if the audio is selected. If not, you can select them right here. Check if the microphone is correctly selected, also the P15. You can always do a test with the mic. So here you can always check if all the devices are correctly selected. Now, back to the full screen. Hopefully you enjoyed all the settings of the Poly Lens app. As I said, it's in full development, I expect quite some more updates in the future. But as I said, I will keep you updated on my YouTube channel. There are two things which I wanted to mention. One, an I don't know if they've mentioned that earlier, but there is an out of the box sort of sticker which you need to take off, because this will block the lens. So there is a sort of sticker, as you can see, on the lens. Don't forget to take it off. Yes, I've seen it in the field there. So it's by default to protect it in the box. So that is the first one. The second one, which I wanted to mention, is the light that I used earlier, the USB light. I got a lot of questions about that. If you can use it also on other products. And also, of course, you can use the light on the P15. So, of course, and those new products already have high quality sensor set for low light conditions. Of course, it's already there. But I can imagine in some situations when you want to stream something or point to specific products or anything, you want to have some additional light. So also with the P15, if needed, you can plug in that additional LED light and you get some additional power in the room. So that is always a possibility. Again, not needed, but could be a possibility if you want to have an extra boost of light in the room. And the nice thing is it's all built in, and you can just use that hub in this device. Now, that was the P5 in the last video, the P15. So you can already guess, hopefully soon, as a next product which I will be unboxing for you. Hopefully you enjoyed it, and again, I'm already looking forward to the next video. See you the next time.